Hi, congratulations. First of all, like I've given many attempts before, so I want to know about prelims because it's a very big challenge to clear prelims. Like any opinion, like what should we do for prelims?
Okay, so as we have seen in the last couple of years, the standard of prelims is only getting more and more difficult, particularly in light of the paper that we got this year. Although all of us have cleared, we were of a unanimous opinion that it was much more difficult than last year's paper. That being the first point. Second point is the fact that the vacancies have been decreasing, as you can see. This year they've been around 780 vacancies in total, which brings down the number of people that are going to write mains, that are going to qualify prelims. So competition is only going to increase and it's going to become more brutal in the future. Now, keeping those two things in mind, I think the only weapon that you have in your hand is practice, is doing a lot of mock papers, okay? A lot of mock tests in a timed environment. You give 2 hours each, but more than solving these papers, and now I'm talking to you particularly because you have already given the exam. So I won't focus on the kind of preparation that is needed. You do the basic books, you do current affairs, which is what everybody does. But that is no longer enough, right? You also need to do a lot of practice. So in a timed environment, solve a paper and then analyze it. Okay, spend 3-4 hours analyzing the paper. Solve about 30 to 40 questions to understand the kind of papers, to understand the kind of questions that are being asked. And then what I would do is, I would draw up a matrix of 10 by 10. And for every question I knew and got right, I would have a different color. For every question I knew but I got wrong, I would have a different color. Every question I guessed, a different color. Every question I guessed which came out wrong, a different color. So once you solve, say around 25-30 mocks, you will have a rough idea of what your optimum number of questions that you must attempt is, what your balance is, how much risk you can take in the exam. And trust me, it's very important to have this idea before you walk into the examination hall. So try doing that. Try going through the kind of questions that are being asked. Because as you can see, in particularly talking about this year's and last year's paper, you cannot find such questions in traditional, conventional sources. Even the current affairs module may or may not cover these obscure topics. So firstly, keep yourself open to all kinds of information. And secondly, use elimination when you are solving the such questions, okay? Use logic by a bare understanding of your basics. Try reducing those 4 options to 2 probable options and take an educated guess. Because I feel that is the only way you can go about it. And on the day of the examination, just don't have any blockade or any preconceived notions about the exam. Because every year the kind of questions that are being asked, it is going to throw everyone out of gear, okay? So just be open to it. Try being as smart and as agile you can in the exam. And stay calm. That is the only input that I can give. And hope for the best. Try having a, because every year there are people who are scoring considerably more than the cutoff. So it is not a completely undoable feat. It is not something that cannot be achieved. If people out there can do it, so can all of you. And that only comes by doing mocks and understanding the nature of questions that are being asked. Thank you.